So today you're 601 pounds.
Yes.
All right. So what is your ability now to be able to get up and walk?
I don't have a lot of distance in walking because my knees are so bad. Just trying to put some of my weight into the walker.
So in the span of a day, how many times you get up and walk?
Well, every time I need to use the bathroom. So 4 or 5.
So you don't move much really, huh?
I haven't been, no.
So at this point, you're not a candidate for surgery, but you want to go ahead and make some changes and eat only high-protein diet.
Okay.
Avoid all the carbohydrate and stick with the total calorie diet a day.
Wow. Okay.
So the type of food that you need to avoid, candy, cookies, sweets, chocolate.
Peanut butter cups.
Peanut butter cups.
Okay. That will be hard.
All right. My expectation would be in 1 month, you should be able to lose at least 50 pounds.
Wow. Okay. All right.
You have to do this now because your body cannot physically handle any surgery at this point. So if something happened to you, there is nothing we can do to save you.
Okay.
Well, it's nice to meet you.
Okay. Thank you.
We'll see you in a month.
It's been a few weeks since I moved to Houston and had my first doctor's appointment. And I've been working to stay on this diet. It hasn't been easy, though. Megan has been making all the food we eat, so I haven't been able to eat any of the foods I want. It's a big adjustment, but I know I have to do this. The way I was eating in Seattle was really toxic. Lots of pizza, lots of Mexican food, lots of delivery. My diet from when I was in Seattle to now is night and day, from super unhealthy to very healthy, and I'm just so pleased with that. Before I started this transition, this plate would have just been absolutely heaping with food. And when I was finished with this plate, there would have been a dessert or maybe two to eat afterwards.
Are you done?
I am.
Totally?
Thank you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very good.
In general, she's been doing very well. She is very motivated and very steadfast in the diet. She's been very good with sticking to it.
But I know she's only eating right because we're making her. So I'm hoping if she's just able to get the surgery, then the changes will really stick.
Today, I'm going to see Dr. Nowzaradan again, and I'm hoping I lost the weight I needed to. Paul is going to help me, but Megan is staying with the kids. And I'm hoping I get to come back home and tell them I did it, that I made them proud.
Hey, how y'all doing?
Doing really well.
Good.
All right. So you lost like 44 pounds?
I know. I'm absolutely thrilled.
Difficult for you to lose that weight?
No, I've just been sticking to the plan as much as possible. Since we've been in the house, it's been easier because we have control of the food more.
Okay, well, that is a positive change, and I'm proud of you for that. But you still should have been able to make a little bit more progress. How's your level of activity?
That needs to improve. I tried walking in with my bone-on-bone knee. That wasn't a good idea.
How about doing upper body exercise?
Yeah, I've got some light weights that I can do.
Okay. Diana has done well. It's not 50 pounds, but it is good progress. But she still talks like she's in control. But this progress is more the result of her enabler changing their dynamic. And that's good, but she still didn't make as much progress that she should have. So you're not approved for surgery at the moment.
Okay.
But I want you to keep trying. And I want to set up a call with your niece to go over the meals she's making to see what you're all eating.
Mm-hmm.
Every month you need to lose 40 pounds.
Okay.
This is going to be the goal that we're going to set. And if you stick with the low calorie, high protein diet, you should easily be able to lose 40 pounds a month.
Okay.
Okay, stick with it.
My first appointment with Dr. Nowzaradan lost 44 pounds, which was amazing. I was absolutely thrilled. And then he said, go lose another 40 pounds this month. That's very intimidating. And one of the things that's happened at the beginning of this journey is I've become more and more aware of how disabled I am. And I think some days, because I'm not very mobile and I can't exercise very much, I feel like 40 pounds is impossible for me. So what I'm doing this month is I'm adding in exercise, and I'm not really capable of doing a whole lot, but I found a seated exercise video that I'm doing. So that's probably one of the biggest changes I have going is movement.
Megan also talked to Dr. Now, and we are on a stricter diet now.
So everything in the refrigerator is very healthy. A non-fat yogurt, eggs, iced tea, broccoli. We had produce come yesterday from the farmer's market. They delivered, so I'm pretty much set.
This month has been harder than the first. It's taken a lot more willpower to keep going. But I go back to the doctor in 2 weeks, and when I do, I want to hit the goal he needs so I can get surgery.
Oops, let's see.
I'm really hoping I hit my goal. Dr. Now said I had to lose 40 pounds and get under 517 pounds this past month. And I'm nervous I'm not gonna hit the number I need again. I don't know if I have many more chances if I didn't lose enough.
Oh no, wow, that's awesome. That means I am under 500 pounds. For the first time in years. Absolutely years. That is amazing.
I'm so proud of myself right now. And I hope Dr. Nalzarden thinks it's enough for weight loss surgery.
So I will approve you for weight loss surgery, but only if your family agrees to stay here in Houston for a while longer, until you start dealing with the issues driving you to eat in therapy after surgery.
Okay.
And if they don't, I'm not going to feel comfortable moving ahead with the surgery, okay?
Okay, yeah, makes sense.
But is that something everyone can agree to?
Mm-hmm.
All right, then I'm approving you for weight loss surgery.
Yay, that's
so
awesome.
So y'all keep up the good work, and I'll see you soon.
Thank you, Dr. Mazzone. Bye-bye. All right, next steps. All right. I'm feeling really excited that I'm approved for weight loss surgery, so that's a big celebration for me. All right, you go ahead and go out, and I'm going to be behind you. All right? All right.
I just want to get the kids out of here and get this over with. Do I think she has the motivation to do it on her own? I have no idea. She never proved to me she did it on her own. She just proved that she could do it with me. I'm feeding her 900 calories a day. Of course she lost weight. What am I supposed to do?
This is not your responsibility as friends.
I know my family has sacrificed a lot to help me get here. And I'm so thankful for all they've done. I know it's a lot for them, but they're saving my life.